Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. In this concluding episode, I will share with you my experiences in the Indian Air Force when I was posted to Chabua near Dibrugarh in the state of Assam in India. When I was in the Jodhpur, I got an information that I was posted to Assam. And I was with my wife, and somehow I couldn't digest the information of being posted to Assam. Why? Because I loved Jodhpur very much, because people are very warm and friendly, and Jodhpur is very close to my heart, because I transformed myself and I became ambitious, and I acquired qualifications, and I acquired lots of learning in Jodhpur. And above all, I got married in 1990 when I was in Jodhpur. So there are many sweet memories. So I didn't like to leave Jodhpur, but I had to leave due to service exigencies. My wife and I packed all the luggage, and we went to Jodhpur railway station and boarded the train to New Delhi. And then again from New Delhi, we went to Guwahati. Then again from Guwahati to we went to Tinsukia railway station. So we have faced so many challenges during the journey, and it was full of challenges, and it was first time for me to go along with my wife to a different unit with lots of luggage. Previously I used to go alone with a metal trunk box. So now I had more luggage. After I reached Tinsukia railway station, a friend of mine came, and we went by Air Force vehicle to the Chabua Air Force station, where we got a single bedroom temporary accommodation. Subsequently, we got Air Force quarters, and we lived there. The specialty of Chabua Air Force Station is that we were blessed with a son, and he is a new addition to our family. So it was more responsibility for us. Often he was not well, and we used to go to hospital to take care of his health. And coming to the work front, we lived in Chabua Air Force Station, but I had to work in Mohanbari Air Force Station. Daily morning, I used to get up at 4 o'clock, and we used to go by Air Force vehicle to Mohanbari Air Force Station, where helicopter unit is based. And I used to work there morning to evening. Then again, in the evening, I used to return to Chabua. That means Chabua Air Force Station, we lived, but I worked in Mi-17 helicopter in Mohanbari Air Force Station. The life was very challenging, full of pressure. And I had to travel different parts of northeastern states, such as some of the places which are in Arunachal Pradesh. They are Jiro, Pasikat, Along, Kelong, Itanagar, Tawang. I traveled, I enjoyed. It was an amazing experience. Ordinary person can't enjoy this kind of life that I led. I went by Mi-17 helicopter, and which was a VIP helicopter, and I had the privilege to travel with many celebrities, leaders, top leaders from India. And also I went many times to different parts of Arunachal Pradesh to evacuate the people who were stranded there, tribals, some local people, they were stranded. We used to go and evacuate the people. It was a great feeling for me, because I was serving the local communities there. Apart from serving my nation, I was serving the people, helping the people. So I was very happy in that way. Whenever I went to different parts of northeastern state, I used to go to All India Radio Station, and I used to give talks. So this is the thing I used to do it. And secondly, what I developed during my stay in Chabua was that I used to carry a book always with me to read. Whenever I found time, I used to read, one. Second, I used to carry a notebook and a pen always with me to jot down my the ideas that flash on my mind. So I started cultivating the habit of reading books and jotting down the things, especially the ideas that flash on my mind. So these are all the things. It was good, but the problem was that I could not become an officer in the Indian Air Force. My career came to a standstill. So I was thinking what to do. Then my father-in-law invited me to join his trading business in Chennai. Then I was exploring what to do. Then I was also doing my MBA at that time. And I used to go from Chabwa to Guwahati to write the examinations. After going there, then exams were cancelled due to some hesitations in Assam. In those days, there were several hesitations in Assam. Life came to a standstill. So most of the times I used to go from Chabwa to Guwahati by train, and I used to return without writing the examinations. So I developed persistence during that period, but I never gave up. So likewise, so many challenges. So more family responsibilities, more challenges. And even then I didn't compromise with my education and learning. Still, I was passionate to pursue my education. So after seeing all these things, and my father-in-law has invited me to join his trading business. He promised that he would set up a factory for me. Then I thought, why not to settle down in one place? Then I applied for discharge on educational grounds. Then I got permission to leave the service. So I discontinued my service. So I don't get any pension now. So the life in Chabwa from 1991 to 1993 is memorable indeed. It was exciting, interesting, full of challenges. I learned. So what I learned during my entire Air Force journey is that India is a land of unity and diversity. There are too many religions, too many languages, too many dialects, different faiths, different beliefs. Even then, all Indians are connected emotionally into one platform. I had the privilege to travel various parts when I served in the Indian Air Force. I joined as a boy, came out as a man, and grew as a leader with several qualifications. And Air Force relieved me from my toxic family background. I was happy that I was out of my toxic family background and acquired my qualifications. Although I could not become an officer, I was happy that I became a positive citizen, healthy citizen, and I grew as a leader. I became ambitious and acquired a couple of qualifications. I became more confident, I became more persistent. So the takeaway from this video is that I personally feel is that it's an honor to be born in a country like India. Although Indians may not have rich, but they are rich in hearts. They all Indians unite emotionally into one platform, despite having several differences because of faiths, beliefs, languages, and religions. So this is my observation about India. The takeaway from this video is that life takes its own turn, and everything happens for a reason. I would appreciate if you could like my video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and turn on notifications.